Okay, so let's continue. So we are now in go to chapter 3. So chapter 3 is on combinational circuit design. All right, we can see what is combinational circuit design. Actually, you have learned this in your digital electronic. And also in diploma, and when you design, for example, a logic circuit, yeah, that involve especially the clock, right? So that's all are actually the combinational circuit. Okay, so look at the outline. So what you will learn in this chapter, so first thing is you will learn the decoder and multiplexer. So this is actually been introduced to you in the previous course, but we will look into detail and we will look at the application also. Before this, you may know what is decoder and what is multiplexer, but you I believe you don't know what is the actual the real application of these two circuit. So the decoder and multiplexer is actually very fundamental and used a lot in digital system, especially in the microprocessor. For example, decoder, when you want to design the memory, want to decode the address of the memory in your processor, on your digital system. So normally we use the decoder. Or sometimes you have many devices, and you want to activate one device at a time. So we use decoder also to decode which one to be activated at a time. All right. So or maybe you want to decode the code for any specific output. For example, seven segment display. All right, we use decoder also to decode the input to the seven segment output. Next is the multiplexer, been introduced to you in the previous chapter also. All right, so we know already the multiplexer is used to select the signal which will go to the output at a time. At a time only one signal is allowed to go to the output. So this is very useful in bus design, right? So in computer system, in microprocessor, so we have many buses, many buses. So at one time, only one of the signal in the bus is allowed to enter the module, any module that we have. For example, want to put in the memory, all right. So we use multiplexer to select which one to go, all right. So that is the use of multiplexer. So we will use these two circuit a lot later in chapter 4, chapter 5, chapter 6. We will use a lot of multiplexer and decoder, right. Next, we will look at the comparator. So there are two types of comparator. The first one we call the magnitude comparator, and the second one is called the arithmetic comparator. So we will look both. And the one that used in the computer is arithmetic comparator. And this one is the magnitude comparator. All right, we will see what is the difference between the two. All right, we will learn both. Both of them. We will look at the adder, although you have been introduced to adder before, but in this course, we will look at the very detail of the adder, how the adder is used, how the adder is designed actually, and how to apply, how to use the adder later on, all right? And also, how we design what is called the subtractor, and how is it designed, and what is the relation of the subtractor and the sign number, all right? And we will see the multiplier also, all right? How to design a multiplier, very costly circuit, a very big circuit, all right. And we will look at arithmetic comparator, all right. So we have two comparator. The first one is magnitude comparator, and the second one is arithmetic comparator. And the last one, we will when we learn all of this, we will build a big circuit, for example, an arithmetic logic unit or an ALU. So the ALU is a very, very useful circuit that every single microprocessor that you have nowadays, all right, will has this ALU inside, all right. So the number is trillion. So every single thing that you have got ALU inside, all right. All right. So let's go to the first one. First thing first is that you need to understand what combinational circuit is. So combinational circuit is actually a circuit, a digital circuit that the output of the circuit is depend on the present input combination input values. Means that if you have the maybe draw on tablet, so let's change the view to this. Okay, can you see the screen? Can you see?
Yes,
good. So what is combinational circuit? Combinational circuit is simply a circuit that the output will change immediately after one or more of the input change. So for example, we have our combinational circuit in a box. All right, so you have a series of input A, B, C, D, and you have series of output also X, Y, Z. All right, this is combinational circuit, or sometimes people in the design field say combo, combinational circuit. So the output here X, Y, Z, we change immediately. Almost immediately, we call it whenever any of this change, any of this input change, all right. So this will change immediately. So just like your simple gate design, for example, this you have F, you have A, B, C, all right. So when you look at this, F will change immediately after C or B or A change, right? So meaning that any changes in at the input will immediately affect the output. So that is the combinational circuit. All right. So the another kind of circuit is called sequential circuit. So there are two types of digital circuit actually. So the first one is combinational circuit, the one that we will learn in this chapter, chapter 3. And the second one is the sequential circuit that we will learn in chapter 4. All right. So sequential circuit is another kind of digital circuit that the output is changed or depend not only the present value of input, but also the history of the output. All right. So you need to differentiate between the two, combo, combinational circuit, the output change whenever the input change. But for sequential circuit, the output change depend on two factor. One is the input, and the other one is the history of the output. Alright, so means that there is a element, history element or memory element in sequential circuit. Alright, in combinational circuit, there is no history. or memory element. Alright, so that is the difference between the two. Okay, so now let's go to the first combinational circuit decoder. So what is a decoder? So this is the block diagram of the decoder, where we have block series of input or n of input here, and we have 2 power of n in output here. Means that if your input is 2 bit, 2, your output will be 2 power of 2, will be 4. Alright? If your input is 3, your output will be 2 power of 3, will be 8, and so on. Alright? So that is the general structure of the decoder. And you may have another signal, we call it enable. So this signal is just to enable your decoder. So when it is activated, means that the output will be activated. If not, it is not activated. Although you change the input, the output will be always 0, for example. Alright, so let's look at the first one, which is the very basic decoder. 2 to 4 decoder, right? See, if you have 2 inputs, so you have 4 output, alright, and you have 1 enable input. So let looks at the truth table of the decoder. So you can see that whenever EN equal to 0, so we don't care what are W0 and W1. Yeah, don't care. So the output will always be 0, alright, when enable is 0. But when enable is 1, yeah. Alright, so the output will depend on the input. Alright, so for example, in this case, when the input here W1 and W0 is equal to 0, so Y0 will be 1 and the rest are 0. Alright, and when we change to 0, 1, so Y1 is 1 and the others are 0, and for this 1, 0, Y2 1, 1, Y3. Alright, means that at one time, one signal is activated based on this combination W1 and W0, right? So this is good if you want to connect, alright, this to another chip, for example, IC, right? So you have another IC here, IC1, this one is IC number 2, this one is IC number 3, this one is IC number 4. So, for example, at one time, you want to activate this IC1, so you just send 00 to W0 and W1, so that this one is activated, but this one is not activated, right? So, of course, this signal is connected to enable circuit of the IC. So, when you look at the IC, normally the IC, or the module, so you have the enable also, enable. Alright, you have pins, port here, and you want enable. So this signal can be connected to that enable signal on the IC. Alright, to activate the IC. Okay, that is the use of the decoder. Alright, and what is the structure or the circuit inside? So this is the circuit inside, and this is exactly based on the truth table. So Y0 is not W0, not W1, Y0 is not W0 and not W1 and enable, right? So exactly based on this truth table. All right. And Y1, Y2, Y3 is the same. So very easily we can. So if we have the equation, right? Y0, Y0 equal to W0, W1, EN, All right, y1 equal to y1, you have w0, w1, not en, and so on. So if we have this, means that we can easily write the code for the decoder in Verilog, right, using data flow modeling. Okay, using assign keyword, assign y0 equal to not w0 and not w1 and en, and so on, quite easily. But in this example, we will use the behavioral modeling. Yeah, so in this case is the behavior of model the decoder circuit using the behavior of the circuit. So let's see how we do that. All right, this is very interesting, so please you should pay full attention to this. Yeah, so the name of the circuit is DEC224, and the port list is WYNEN. All right, if we look at here, right, we actually have many input and output, right? W we have 2, Y we have 4, EN we have 1. So in total, we have how many? We have 4 plus 3, 7, 7. But when we see, this output is in the same group, right? Y, and this is W, this is N. So actually, we can group this signal together. We can group this signal together to be this one is only Y, this one is only W, and EN. So how to do that in Verilog? So we should have only Y, W, Y, and EN. All right. So and then we tell the compiler that W is actually 2-bit, which is 1 and 0. Here means that W, we have 2W, and we have W0, and also W1. Yeah? All right, 1 and 0, or 0 and 1, W. And we have EN, and EN is only 1-bit, yeah? So no need to have something like this. And the output is 4-bit, so we can write 0, 3. And why is it 0, 3? This one is 1, 0. Why not 3, 0? The answer is that it is based on what is your specification. Yeah. So in this case, our specification is like this. Yeah? In the truth table, you see W is 1, 0. So, yeah. So in W, we write 1, 0. For W, and for Y, we can see that we start with Y0 and end to at Y3. So you can have 0, 3, Y, so that you have Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, and here you have W1 and W0. Okay, so for here, this is exactly based on our truth table. And next is Y also is declared as a rect data type. Y later on. All right, so this one I will explain after this. But look at what inside here, the always block. So whenever you use always block, means that you will describe your circuit using behavioral modeling. All right, so you model your circuit. So always W or EN, and remember this, what is inside this is called sensitivity list. Yeah. All right. Sensitivity list means that the output here, what is the output? The output is Y. Yeah. Y here, all right, is sensitive to what signal? All right. Means that if that particular signal change, all right, that will automatically or immediately change or affect Y, all right. So that must be in the sensitivity list. So in our case, when we look at here, so Y will change depend on, or Y sensitive to these three signals, WN, W0, W1, and EN. Alright, so that is Y. That is why W or EN must be inside the sensitivity list. So there are two ways, yeah, to write this sensitivity list. One way is to use or you can do like this, always W, comma, EN also can, no problem. So sometimes I use comma, sometimes I use or, so don't confuse, both can be used, yeah. Okay. So now we have, you may have begin and of course you need to end with end, but it depends on how many statements you have here. In this case, actually you have if this, else this, so actually no need begin and end, also no problem, but you can have this, yeah, no problem. This consider one statement, yeah, if and else only. Okay, so let's see how to describe using behavioral. Very easy. We use if en equal to 0, all right? So look at the truth table. If en equal to 0, y always 0, right? So that's why we have this. Okay, if en equal to 0, so y, the signal of y always 0. So y here is 4-bit, yeah? Y here is 4-bit. 4-bit. So this is how we write the 4-bit in Verilog. Alright? In binary. So for this character and B for binary number. So in this case, yeah, here will be y0. And here will be Y3, which is based on what we do here. Alright? Because Y is 0 to 3, means that this is Y0 and this is Y3. If you write Y3, 0, Y, so this will be Y3 and this one will be Y0. And of course, this one is Y1, Y2. Okay? So it depends on how you write the code. Okay, so let's back to this. But if en equal to 0 and else means that if en equal to, in this statement, if en equal to 1, right? So if en equal to 1, what do you do? If en equal to 1, there will be 4 possibilities, right? If en equal to 1 here, there will be 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 possibilities. Okay? So if you have 4 possibilities, you can do 2 approaches. Alright? The first one, you can use if else also. If w equal to 0, y equal to this 1, 0, 0, 0. Else if w equal to 0, 1, y equal to this. Else if Alright, so that is one approach. Another approach is to use case statement. Alright, case statement is very useful if you have many possibilities. Alright, just like you could in C, programming. So how to use case statement? So to use case statement is this case. So case depend on what? Yeah, in this case, case W. Alright? So because W, yeah, we have 4 possibilities. So we use case W. Case W equal to 0, the output should be this. Case W equal to 1, Y should be equal to this. Yeah? Case W equal to 2, Y should be equal to this. So, yeah, W. So this is the value of W, alright? Case, the first case, W equal to 0, or you can write like this, yeah? 2-bit, right? W is actually 2-bit. B00, same thing, yeah, for this, and the second one is 01. All right, here you write in this example, yeah, you write in decimal, decimal, but the compiler, the quarters, will know automatically that this is 2-bit number, yeah, because the compiler know already W is 2-bit, so this is actually 00. All right, so if 00, Y equal to this, yeah, 1000, Y0 is 100, Y3 is 0. And if 01, if W equal to 01, Y should be equal to this. And if W equal to 2, Y should be equal to this. W equal to 3, Y should be equal to this. Alright? And here are all the possibilities already. So you have four possibilities only. 0, 2, 3, yeah, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 possibilities, alright, so done already. So you need to have AND case here, alright, to close the case statement here, and this one is to end the begin here, alright, done, AND module. So when you do this, you will get the 2 to 4 decoder, alright, using the behavioral modeling. Okay, and one more thing. Why here? Why is declared as reg data type as well? Although here we declare Y as an output, right? As output here. Here you need to remember that whenever you assign any value to a variable inside the always block. So where is your always block? So this is your always block. And what is your variable? Y is your variable, right? Y is your variable. So you assign a value. What value? This value. This value to Y. So whenever you assign any value to a variable inside an always block, so that variable must be declared as reg data type. Remember that. All right. So here, these two statements actually you can combine to be something like this: output reg 03 Y. All right. So instead of write two statements like this, so you can combine to be output right 03 Y. All right, so if you don't have this, when you compile your design, when you synthesize your design, the compiler, the quarters tool, will give you syntax error. We give you error, for example, for sure. All right, the red message. Okay. Alright, so that is decoder. Do we have any other decoder? Yes, we have. Here is the same. So, same things here. Just combine graphical symbol, the truth table, and the code, so that you can refer easily that this one is actually based on this truth table. The code is the behavioral modeling. Another approach of modeling is to use the structural modeling. So you can see, because you have the schematic of the decoder, so you can use the structural. So you see, you use gate instantiation here, and Y0, so the output is Y0, not W0, so this is not W0, and this is not W1, and EN is the input. So you have this AND gate, and the second AND gate is this one, third and fourth, the AND gate. So you will get the same output, the same result. Yeah. So this one is okay, looks easy when you have this, yeah. But when your circuit is big, definitely you don't have the schematic, yeah, and you need to go for this one. For example, this one, all right, this is quite a bigger circuit as compared to the previous one. So this is the 3-to-8 decoder, and remember, when you have 3 input, so the output will be 8, yeah, 2 power of 3, and you have 2-to-4 decoder here, means that you use, you reuse the previous design, means that this design, this one or this one, either one, you can be used. So let's, for example, we use this one to create this one. So again, this is used hierarchical design methodology, right? You use a smaller design to create a bigger design, right? This is a small design, smaller design, 2-to-4, to create a 3-to-8, yeah, which is the, of course, the bigger design. So this is the truth table of the decoder. So from this truth table, actually, we can come out with a design like this. So how to get this? Maybe we can be explained from the truth table. So for example, how we activate this part. So when we look at this, this is from Y0 to Y3, so should be this part, not including this one, because this one is when enable is equal to 0. So we look at when enable equal to 0, all the output, all the output will be 0. But when for Y0 to Y3, so in this box, look carefully. All right, the time that the output is activated, right? Whether this one, and for this part, you see all are 0. So we look at this one. So how to create this output? So we can use the this W2 signal, because we can see that when this one is activated, this part is activated, so W2 must be 0, right? W2 must be 0, and you see W0 and W1 is 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, so should be same as the previous connection, right? 0 1 0. But to activate this part, so you need to make W2 equal to 0. All right, so this is how. All right, W2 equal to 0. So if you have this part, this part equal to this input equal to 0 and enable equal to W2 equal to 0 and enable equal to 1, because we want to enable this part. Of course, the enable must be 1, alright? So if W2 equal to 0, here should be 1, and the output should be 1. This should be enable this one, and if this one is 0, so this output should be 0, so this part is disabled, alright? So when this happens, so the output here will depend on these two value. So that's why we have these two value will activate this part. And whenever W2 is 0. Whenever W2 equal to 1, for example, so let's see. Whenever W2 equal to 1, alright. So this part is not activated, and this part is activated now. Alright, and when we look at the circuit, when W 2 equal to 1. So here should be 0. And enable, of course, we need to make it 1 to enable the 2 to 4 decoder. And this should be 0, and this one will be deactivated. And this is 1 and 1, so this one is activated. So this signal will be dependent on these two, W0 and W1. So that's why you have 1 and W0 and W1 here, and this one is activated now, Y4, Y5, Y6, Y7, depend on this combination. Alright, that's why you have this circuit, yeah? Okay. Or you can build the 3-to-8 decoder using case statement, just like we did for 2-to-4 decoder. Alright, from, of course, by using this truth table. Alright, but in this example, we use the previous 2-to-4 decoder, 2-to-4 decoder, to build the 3-to-8 decoder. Okay, so we have the circuit now. We have the circuit now, and this is how to write the code. So maybe here is better view so that we can see clearly. Okay, so again, we need to use a combination of design approach, but actually I don't like this part of code using behavioral, because here we have this, so we should have the equation for the output here and here. So let's change this a little bit, so in your notes also, so please change to this. So this part, I don't want. Instead, you replace with the data flow modeling. So, all right, let's cancel this out first. We don't want this. Don't want. All right. So, the code will be like this. Module DEC. The name is DEC 3-to-8. All right, and the port list is still W. So we have W. Now is 3-bit. Y is now 8-bit, and EN is still 1-bit. So that's why we have input W is 2-to-0. So means that we have W2, W1, and W0, and input 1-bit. Output is 0-to-7. You see, we have 0-to-7. So you have 0-7. Y. So Y is from 0 to 7, and Z. Z is actually the internal signal here. So you have Z0 and Z1, and in this case we want to use the data flow modeling. So instead of using rack, so we change to wire. Right, change to wire. So you have Z0 and Z1. So where is Z0? This is Z0. Z0, and here is Z1. Alright. So, and let's say for example we instantiate. We create these two modules first. We call from our previous design. So how to call? Again, you need to write the name of this module. Because our name, remember the name of this module is where is it? Is DE224, DEC or DE? DEC, DEC 224. So the name here is DEC 224, means that we use that module, and the name for the first one, for example, we call it M1. And the second one, we call it M2. So in this case, M1 here. So we use the port positioning port map, right? So this is how we arrange the signal. So the W is W1 to W0. So let's look at the previous design. Yeah. So we have W, Y, E, N. All right, and W is 1, 0. So 1, 0, yeah. W, Y, E, N. So this is the arrangement. So when we go back to here, okay, so yeah. Can you see this? Wait. Okay. Here is W 1, 0. So means that these two signal, all right, connect to this. And Y is, yeah, the first one is Y0 to Y3. So exactly, this is Y0 to Y3, and the enable for this module is connected to Z0. That's why we have Z0 here. And for the second one, the W connected to the same W0 and W1, so should be the same as this one. And for the Y, we connect to Y4 to Y7, so 4 to 7 here. And the enable here is connected to Z1. That's why we have Z1. And now we want to create or to derive signal Z0, how to derive signal Z0 or derive this circuit, yeah, to get Z0. So we can use data flow modeling. All right, so we can use assign Z0 is equal to, what is this? This is not W2, all right, not W2, N, this is N gate, N with enable. So you can N with E, N, right? So you can get Z0. Now the second one, you want to get Z1. So Z1 is very easy, which is W2, N, enable. Right, N enable. So you can use assign also. Assign Z1 is W2 and EN. Alright, so you can have this code replace this part, or you can put after this, no problem. All right. Okay, so that will be the decoder. Another example of decoder application is the 7-segment decoder. All right, where you want to design an application that use a 7-segment decoder as your output, yeah. So you need to have what is called a code decoder, and this will decode, yeah, the output, yeah, from a binary number here to the code that will turn on the LED here based on the number that you want. For example, you want to display number 0, so this A, B, C, D, E, F must be turned on and G should be turned off, right? And if we want to display number 1, so B and C must turn on and the rest must be turned off, right? So the decoder is like this. So you have 4 input. You may have enable input. Whenever enable is say 0, so the output, all the output is 0, or there is no output. All right, in this case you don't have. So whenever W equal to 0, So all are 0. So we want to display 0. So means that A, B, C, D, E, F should be 1. And G should be 0. Eh? In this case, it's active high. Eh? Alright. When your W is 1 eh? Or 0, 0, 0, 1. Eh? 1 means that we want to display number 1. So B and C must be 1. Right, so that you see 1, 1, and the rest are 0. So we display number 1. And for others, for example, number 2, this is the code for number 2, and number 9, this is the code for number 9. Should we have number 10? No, eh? Because one digit of a 7 segment display can only display up to from 0 to 9. Eh? All right, that's why we have until 9 only. Okay, so what about the code? So this is the code. Yeah. So the code is quite easy. Because we have, remember, we have a very good modeling style that although the specification is look complicated, yeah, the truth table it look big, you have how many output here? You have 7 output, you have, and also each output you have 4 bit input, yeah. But because you have the behavioral design modeling, so you can straight away model or write your code based on this truth table, all right, just like we did in 2 to 4 decoder just now. So we have, if look at this, we can have two group of input only, right? One group of input only. So this is one group, this is another group. So in the code, actually the input is called BCD, the output is called LEDS. So let's name this as LED, is it S? BCD, yeah? So the input is BCD, and the output is LEDS, right? So means that this one must be L BCD CD 3, yeah. This one is BCD 2, and this one is BCD 0, and this one will be LED S 0. And the last one will be LED. Let's hold on. Look at how we declare this. Oh, sorry. So 1, eh? 1 to 7, 3 to 0. So LED S is a little bit. Yeah. So it's not 0, but 1. So it should be 1, this one is LED 1, this is LED 2, until the last one is LED S 7, alright? This one is 3 to 0, correct? So the specification is like that. So again, we go to the code. Alright, let's look at the code. Very straightforward. We can see input is BCD and the output is LED and BCD. The input is 4 bit, 3 to 0. And the output is LEDS, and start from 1, LEDS 1, LEDS 2, 3, until LEDS 7. And again, LEDS is declared also as a red, right? Because LEDS, you see, is inside the always block. Yeah, we assign value to LEDS in always block. And that is why we declare LEDS as a rect data type. Alright, and again you can write like this actually. Output rect 1 7 LEDS. Okay. So to replace this 2. Alright. And straight away, because we don't have any enable signal, so we can straight away use the case statement. So case what? Case BCD, right? Because it's depend, the output LEDS here is depending on sorry. Is depending on the BCD signal. So case BCD, and if BCD equal to 0 or 4 bit, 0 0 0 0, and the output of LEDS should be this, and this will display number 0, and if 0 0 0 1, the output should be this value which display number 1. All right. But now, one thing you need to observe here is that you use case statement here, right? But your output, your combination of input here is only from 0 to 9, all right? So you need to remember that when you use case statement, you need to represent actually all the combination that you have, So in this case, you have 4-bit, 4-bit input. So how many combination, possible combination that you should have, all right? So instead of from 0 to 9, actually you need to have from 0 to, all right, number 10, 1010, until the last one will be 1111, which is actually number 15, right? So the maximum value of W, or in this case is BCD, actually can start from 0 to 15, 15, all right, because you have 16 combinations, possible combination from 0 to 15. But in your code, you only define from 0 to 9, all right. So in the code, to prevent the compiler to synthesize the memory component or memory circuit for you for free, all right? So you need to avoid that by use this keyword, default. Means that for others combination, other than 0 to 9, default, the LED, the value of LED, the output is don't care, all right? This is don't care, all right? By doing this, compiler will not give you memory circuit. All right. If you don't have this, all right, whenever the input is not in this combination, for example, it can be, right? It can be 10, 11. So, for example, the input is 11. So, what is the output? You not define here. When you not define here, it will give you the previous. Output value, all right. But in this case, when you said don't care, means that there's no output, all right. And you end case here, all right, means that finish the code is finished, and end module, all right. So this will give you the 7-segment decoder. All right. Any questions so far? Okay. So if no other question, we will stop our class here. The time is good, 10:50. So we will continue next week. Thank you very much. See you next week.